In this video, we are going to talk about the limits of trigonometric functions. So, let's consider the trigonometric functions. So, the first thing I want to consider, let A is a real number, in the domain of given trigonometric functions the reason why I'm taking the domain, or I should say the reason why I'm taking the point in the domain of the given trigonometric functions, because if the trigonometric function is not, or I should say, if the trigonometric function does not exist for that particular point, then we cannot find the limit. So, only way we can find the limit of any trigonometric function if the point is in the domain of the given trigonometric function. Or I should say, it's defined for that value. So, let's first consider our first trigonometric function. So, my first trigonometric function is limit x tends to a sine x is, if I find the limit at any point a for sine function, I will get sine of a. My second trigonometric function is limit x tends to a cosine function of x is basically, I will get cosine of a, right? And my third trigonometric function is, for limit x tends to a tangent x, right? And that will be equal to tangent of a, right? My next trigonometric function, which is the fourth one, is limit of x tends to a cosecant of x, that is equal to cosecant of a. My fifth trigonometric function is my secant function. So I will write limit x tends to a secant of x is equal to secant of a. And my last trigonometric function that I'm going to consider is my sixth one, and that is limit x tends to a of cotangent function x is equal to cotangent of a. So, as you can see, if the point is a real number and the point is in the domain of the given trigonometric function, we can find the limit of that trigonometric function. And the way we need to find the limit of that trigonometric function is basically substituting that real number for that trigonometric function. So for an example, if I want to find the limit of trigonometric function at point A, and let's for this example, my function is sine, what will I do? I will substitute A for x. And in the same way, I will substitute A for x in all the trigonometric functions, right? To find the limit of trigonometric function at any real point in the given domain of that particular trigonometric function. And this is how we will find the limit of trigonometric function.